Hello, beautiful soul. Welcome to the Her Soulful Success podcast. I am Diana Ricciotti, certified coach of NLP, certified timeline therapy practitioner, business mentor, and the girl who went from corporate climbing to solopreneur, replacing her full-time income working part-time hours in her business while juggling mum life. But you, my friend, can call me D, because I know quite literally that we're going to become business besties. This space is for you to escape into, away from the crazy hustle in your business and life, to get your weekly mindset fix, your business boost, your realignment with the highest and best version of yourself, and your dose of self-development. All ingredients that I believe for a soulfully successful business, where abundance and fulfillment go hand in hand. Whether you're doing the 9-to-5 grind and dreaming about there being something more out there for you, whether you're wanting to explode your side hustle, or you are already a business owner feeling maybe a little lost, stuck, or overwhelmed, this podcast is designed to speak to your soul. So without further ado, let's jump into this week's podcast and level up your mindset so that you can begin living your best life. Hello, beautiful souls, and welcome to episode 2 of the Her Soulful Success podcast. Today, do I have a treat for you? I know that some of you might not currently have a business mentor, so today I decided to share mine. This powerhouse of a woman is nothing other than an inspiration to me, to the girls who are lucky enough to call her their coach, and to the thousands of followers she influences on a daily basis in her business. Not only has she recently celebrated the 1-year anniversary of her business, which she built from the ground up while being a single mum, but she has successfully scaled her business to earning consistently 20k plus month. Her story is one that will move and inspire you, as it is proof of how much you can transform your life even from the most darkest of places by focusing on reconnecting with your soul and transforming your mindset. This story is for women who might need evidence today of how you can make something from nothing. And it seems you, maybe when it seems you have nothing going for you, purely from the strong desire and ability to dream big. So without further ado, I want to introduce to you, welcome the beautiful Luka Rose. Welcome, Luka.
Thank you so much for having me on here. And that intro almost brought tears to my eyes. Thank you so much. That was so beautiful.
What, girl, you bring a tear to my eye almost every day that I work with you. So it's only fair. So Luka, I guess for the listeners who have not had the pleasure of connecting with you before, could you tell us a little bit about what you do, maybe your mission, the kind of clients you serve, and why you do what you do? I know that's a mouthful there, but.
So I'm Luka. I'm a female mindset and startup business coach. I help predominantly female coaches struggling with fear and uncertainty to basically gain clarity and generate consistent income. And what's most important in the work that I do is that they are, with the clients that I work with, is that they're creating a life on their own terms, right? No two people are living the same life. And through my own experiences in business and in motherhood, I've really grown to know that. Mm-hmm. So it's really important for me that the people that I work with are creating a life based on what they desire, because there's no one size fits all. And that's something that I really make sure that I emphasize with anybody that I work with. What's the other half of that question? I'm so sorry.
I absolutely love that. I just wanted to, before clarifying the rest of that question, just add how important that was to me when I decided to work with you, because with social media and access to so much content and so many strategies and so many potential coaches that you could work with, a lot of them take this one-size-fits-all approach. And even though you have this very specific niche, which I'm really passionate about teaching as a mentor myself, you still are all about just being in flow and meeting your client where they're at and making sure that their business fits into their life and is aligned with the way they want to do life, which is so beautiful. We spoke a little bit about the clients you serve, and I guess, why do you do what you do?
Yeah, so where my kind of journey began is very different. I actually never really saw myself helping women in business and on mindset. It was kind of through my own journey of personal development, mm-hmm. and personal growth and my own business experience that got me here. But essentially at the core of it, I am super passionate about about women creating financial independence for themselves. And as I said, I'm really passionate about women creating a life on their own terms. So I, when was it? 2018, I became a single mom. I was 22 and my daughter was 3 to 4 weeks old. I kind of hit the pit of my life, I think you could call it. I was in a domestic violent relationship. I walked away from that with my car, which was worth about, I don't know, $2,000, my baby in the back and all her clothes and a bag full of my clothes. I left behind an entire house full of furniture and I didn't have any savings. I didn't have any kind of income. I left, I think it was $2.50 or something like that in my account. And so it was fair to say that I kind of had hit rock bottom. But from there, after a few weeks, I kind of got fed up with having that little pity party and sitting in that I just decided that I want to be different. I want to do something different. Surely this isn't it. Surely this isn't just what my life is going to be about from now on. And with a lot of people, I read The Secret. I then started to implement and I found manifestation. I loved that. And I've found all these different people with all these amazing teachings, and from forgiveness to gratitude to manifestation, law of attraction, spirituality. And I've just kind of dipped my toe in each of them. And then I really got confident and just delved right in. And through that, I've created a couple of different businesses. Initially, I had a clothing business. I wanted to empower women that at any size that they can wear the same clothes as someone, whether you're size 6 or size 16. Mm-hmm. After doing that for a few months, I realized that wasn't my mission, was still there, but I just felt I could create a stronger impact in a more direct way. So I started hosting events with a friend of mine, and that was amazing. We held, it was called Afternoon with the Girls. We had one of those. And then from there, we then decided that we would both be trained in NLP. From there, I decided to venture off on my own. And yeah, along the way, I was just teaching mindset initially, but now it's changed to mindset and startup business coaching. I'm super passionate about business, and I explained before about women having that financial independence, but also a lifestyle, most importantly. So yeah, in a roundabout way, that's how I got to where I am today.
Wow. How incredible is that story and that journey? And it's funny, you literally answered my next question. If you read my mind, it was around how we often see entrepreneurships at the stage of success. We see sort of the end result of where their businesses are. And I've been creeping on your account just on the download before you became a business coach. So I'm quite familiar with your journey. And it was part of the reason why I was so aligned to wanting to work with you, because I had already seen you try different areas and different businesses. And that's what attracted me to you as a coach. But can you talk to us a little bit about that previous business that you started? I think it was around the activewear, and talk about, well, I guess we're going to use the word failure here, but in a more positive way, because I believe that failure is such a huge part of the journey that is business. And with a business that didn't succeed, or a business that you didn't continue to work to and work with, what's your advice to women in business who are currently fearful of failing?
I would say lean into it, that you can fail. And I mean, let's just delve into that word alone for a second. What do you even perceive failure to be, or what does it even look for you? If failure meant that something didn't work out, then I would be the biggest failure of all time, because I have had countless relationships not work out. I have had business ventures work out. I have had launches that didn't work out. So I think it's really important to identify just within yourself, even, what do you perceive failure to be? My perception of failure is that if you fall down, not getting up and trying again, that's failure. Not even doing anything to begin with, or not even having a go, that to me is more failure than a business that didn't take off.
Yeah.
So I think it's really important to identify what you attach to the word failure. But for me, yeah, I definitely had a failed business, if you will. Forever grateful for that, because without that failure, I would not be here. Because in that business, I found it very hard to, I was new to business. It was an e-commerce store. It required money. It required a lot of time. And I found it really tricky. And one thing that I actually found as well is that, and I think this is the most evident thing that I really found is that it wasn't fully aligned. My highest mission and my highest purpose, it wasn't fully aligned, and that's why it wasn't working out for me. Also, full accountability, that's why I wasn't taking the action on it that was required, because I wasn't in complete alignment with that, with where that was going, because I knew within myself that I could create more than this.
Yeah, that's so, so amazing, because I absolutely used to give failure the meaning of if I didn't get the result that I expected to would mean that I failed. And I would take meanings out of that about myself and about my character and about my abilities in the world. And absolutely, now I just see failure as something that is almost my friend, that is something that I'm going to expect, and I have to come to terms with something that's going to happen on the daily. And almost I'm all for normalizing failure, because it's just really part of the journey. It's just the learning process. And if you're not failing, you're probably not doing enough. Hey, and
I agree. Yeah,
that's it. I love what you said about the aligned feeling in your business too. Sometimes we choose to give up on a business because we're just not feeling, or an idea, or perhaps even a strategy. We've chosen to walk away from it, not because we couldn't take it and make it successful, but because it just didn't feel right or true to us, or was fulfilling us and wasn't driving us enough. So there's two factors there that could, I guess, amount to how we perceive failure as it is.
But. Yeah, totally. And I mean, the other great quality question you could even ask yourself, if you are attempting a business or you're attempting to start one, or everyone's got different goals and aspirations, is identify what failure means to you. But then if you were to fail in your eyes at that, what would you make that mean about yourself? If the business didn't take off how you wanted it to, if you fell short of a goal, what would you then make that mean? Because I know for me, I have targets, I have KPIs, I have things that I need to measure in business. But if I don't hit them, I don't perceive it as I failed. I've tried really hard to work towards something. So next time, I'm just going to have to dissect it and delve in a little bit deeper and work a little bit hard to get the result that I want.
Yeah.
You know, rather than, you know, being defeated by not attaining the thing or the number or whatever it is. What do you make that mean about yourself?
Such a good question. So powerful, Luka. I think everybody needs to just jot that one down into their life. Hey, I'm all about journal prompts. That is such a good quality question. I am all about that. The next question I wanted to ask was, I'm going to track here and serve women out there who have dreams at the moment, but just don't think they're in their ideal situation. Perhaps they might be struggling financially. Perhaps they're experiencing hardships or heartbreaks, or might be thinking it's not the right time for them to start a business. One of the reasons why I explained earlier onto your journey was because we both share the experience of having gone through some traumatic relationships, or particularly one traumatic relationship. You did a wonderful job though of showing up authentically, and that meant so much to me, even though we didn't know each other at the time. And for other women who were going through hard times, and you just rose from those ashes every single day, not always perfectly, but you did it anyway. And from there, you built this incredible business. So what I want to know is, if you're able to share with us your personal mindset transformation and what motivated you to keep going and change your life so freaking drastically.
Yeah, absolutely. Anything mindset, I could get lost and talk about hours. So I'll try to keep this brief. But
yes,
in terms of that first part of your question and kind of like the perfect time to start, there is no perfect time. Or if there was, I highly doubt that being a 22-year-old broke single mom living in her parents' back room with no income was the time to start, right? But what I did was I started anyway, and I didn't have all the pieces. There wasn't a point that I could see that I needed to be at in order to start, right? And that's how I got into a clothing business and then an events business to now coaching in a one-on-one and group capacity, is because I didn't know all the steps, but I did take one step. And after taking that one step from my potential, I then got a small result, which built my belief and my certainty within myself to see even more potential in myself. And I'm still going through through that cycle now. Do you think that you need to have more or be more or attain more or be something else other than what you currently are? The moment that you're not going to take action, you're not going to move closer to what you want to become or what you want to achieve or attain. And I think the most important thing is to just start. I still don't have all the pieces. I still can't see so clearly what my life will look or what it will be in 5 year time or what business will be in 5 years time. Because there are some elements of life that you just cannot see, but you can't see them because they're unfolding far more beautifully than you could even possibly imagine with the way that you think right now. And for me, my mindset built more stronger every single day when I continue to take aligned action that would give me a more beautiful result. Yeah. And I have done practices in the morning. I've had my morning routine. I've had spiritual practices that I do, gratitude practices, all those things, even though everyone bangs on about them all the time, they are so relevant in order to keep your mindset check.
Yes.
To keep it strong. And I know that you mentioned on your first podcast about your mindset being a muscle. That could not be true.
Absolutely.
Yeah. So I think for me, it's just, I didn't have the mindset today that I had 2 years ago. I had to build the mindset, but you've got to remember what got you here won't get you there. There needs to be a shift. You need to incorporate new strategies or new practices day to day in order to build your mindset. And sometimes it's a little bit tricky at the beginning. I think people are under this misconception that if I just do a morning routine, it'll be really easy in the mornings to get out of bed and my days will just flow. Not the case. Yes, some days it will help. Absolutely. It will help in that department. But I think more importantly, it's the self-discipline that you create from doing a morning routine. It's the self-discipline that you create every time that you say you're going to do something and you follow through with it. Because yeah. That mindset and that discipline, you then bring into different other parts of your world, whether that be business or parenting or relationships. But I think, yeah, it definitely starts with good routines and good practices until it just becomes kind of second nature to you.
Yeah. And I absolutely, what resonates with me so much is that believing before seeing, because we're often told we download this belief around seeing is believing. And it's, if you think about even how electricity works, you see it, you just know it's there and it's so freaking powerful. So I just love having that belief that it's enough to just believe that there's something else out there for you and not know all the details between where you are now and the result of that, and really truly believing. And that's the spiritual work that you do in self-development as well, just changing your perspective on what the universe and what this world is designed to help you do. It's designed to help you achieve all of those things. It's really just you usually holding yourself back. So just by believing in that outcome and not knowing all the details in between and just taking that first step, whatever it is, even if it's not the right step, the fastest way of finding out what is not meant for you is doing it, right? And knowing, yeah, and just knowing, hey, that wasn't it. Oh, I absolutely love that. It's such great advice. So beautiful. So we're all going to face our own challenges and failures, but it comforts me to know that as a coach, I can save my clients from repeating some of my own. Right? So this is what also excites me about bringing up. So if you were to give the audience some advice on what you would tell the you if you were just starting your business all over again or starting the business journey, what advice would you give yourself?
I would have gotten a coach. That's what I would have done.
Yes.
I think the mindset of I can do this on my own, I'll just find my way. I believe in that to a degree. And that's the method that I used essentially, because I had the belief that I don't have the money for that. How could I possibly do that? And it wasn't until I actually was fortunate enough to get in proximity with a high performance coach. And she really held me to a high standard. And she just really said to me, if you want to make it happen, you will. And I was, oh my God. And I remember making my investment in her and I was, holy dooly. I have to be open to the fact that I don't have all the pieces. That's why I'm here. Again, what got me here, although I've made tremendous change, will not get me there. And I could find my own way and stuff up, but I was realizing that actually it was costing me time and money more than it was to invest in a coach who had walked the journey before me and who wasn't telling me exactly what to do, but just had the strategy and the resources to help me find my own. So I think when you look at the most high level level professionals in the world, they have someone guiding them and coaching them in that area because they're an expert at that, right? So it makes sense to invest or get in proximity at least with someone who is an expert in the field that you want to be in.
Yeah, absolutely. I've learned so much just from working with you this year. It's incredible. And I can absolutely also feel into that fear around, oh, feeling you can't afford an investment, whether it's a coach or investing in your business in other ways. And that is definitely a fear that I think a lot of solopreneurs are faced with all of the time, particularly I think women, because they always feel this responsibility, especially if they have kids or a family, to their family first, when really sometimes you can't afford the investment because you haven't invested. And I also really believe in getting in proximity with people that are already doing what you want to do, because that's who you really want to just learn on a day. Even sometimes outside of my coaching sessions with yourself, it's just about even just being in a conversation with you. I'm learning, or being able to access your coach as well, and just what you're doing in the online space. It's really great to surround yourself. We in NLP, we always call it the model of excellence, and modeling the behavior of people that are already doing what it is that you want to be doing in business. And yeah, can't do it alone. Yeah, yeah. The solitary journey can be so lonely. It's so important to have that too.
Trying to implement on your own is so important, but at the beginning it can be so hard. And it's the number one thing that I see is that people lack the self-discipline to implement. And again, I think I heard it on your first episode, you were talking about there's so much strategy out there, there's so much free content. So why do people invest in coaches? Why do they get an expert in their field? And a lot of it is having someone to hold you to a high account, having skin in the game to make you show up. The people that I have worked with who have gotten the most tremendous amount of result are the ones that have the most skin in the game, the ones that have not necessarily had the money, but always found the way. And they had so much on the line. It was do or die.
Yeah.
I have to make this happen because I have a family. I have to make this happen because I've left my old full-time income.
Yeah.
I've burned all my boats and now I need to kind of, it's sink or swim. And if you don't have, if you've got a plan B, then I question your plan.
Yeah.
If you have a plan B, you've got one foot in, one foot out, and you subconsciously have an expectation that this probably won't work out, right? I just have one plan, and one way or another I'm going to find a way. And again, this comes back to failure. I'm not going to have one foot in, one foot out waiting to fail so that I can go to my plan B. I just have a plan A, both feet are in the car, and I'm moving forward one way or another. Doesn't matter if I have to push the car, I always change my approach and go again.
Love that. And that resonates with me again, because I felt that way when I was on maternity leave and I still had one foot in the door of the potential reality of going back to my full-time job. It was there. I wasn't getting paid maternity leave anymore. It was there as this backup, quote unquote, backup, something to fall back on if it was that my business didn't succeed. But the minute that I cut ties with that plan B, that was when shit got real. That's when my business blew up and I had more meaningful and aligned conversations with women too, because I have this level of certainty now. And I just, yeah, everything changes when you have that one focus, and that is to succeed in your business, and there is nothing else. There is no plan B. I absolutely love that. It's such great advice, Luka.
I'm so glad. I mean, I think the most important thing as well that you said is you need to be living everything that you're teaching. If you've got one foot in, one foot out, if you're afraid to invest to the point that you don't even invest, then what's going to make someone invest in you?
Absolutely.
It's so important to be living everything that you're teaching, and that's true alignment. And energetically, people
are, so yeah. Speaking of women, sorry to cut you off there, because I've got all these questions just bursting out of me. Speaking of women that have been drawn to you, apart from myself, what are you finding the women that you're currently working with, because you're working with a lot of coaches and women in business as well, what are they struggling with most in their businesses at the moment, and why do you think that is?
I think fear is probably the most common theme that comes through, and possibly the lack of discipline to show up in their business. And again, I think that that comes back to fear, and I think that procrastination and perfectionism and using all those are what's called diminishing behaviors. just, I think there's this overwhelming sense sometimes of more fear of failure than there is of like more possibility of the success. And where your thoughts go, your energy flows. And that's something that I always try to help my clients with, is redirecting their thoughts. Are you focusing on what you want, or are you focusing on what you don't want? Because either way, you're manifesting it into your reality.
Yes. I do a lot of work with my clients around this too. And a great tip that I have around having that quick ability to refocus is obviously, one, becoming aware of your thoughts as much as possible. Mm-hmm. If you can bring as much awareness to your thought patterns as you possibly can and practice that throughout the day, that is step one. And step two is, well, how do I refocus? So sometimes you're just so fixated on this scary thought of what you don't want to happen, and then it freaks you out even more finding out that you're manifesting it and energetically matching it, and then you fall into this panic. I don't know about you, but that's how I used to be. Oh my God, how do I stop this? Cut this vortex off right now. But the easiest way to be in tune with what you're manifesting and the results that you're bringing in is getting in tune with your emotions, right? Because your emotions are a product of your thoughts. So if you're feeling yuck, a bit sad, negative, scared, the negative, uncomfortable feeling, then you can quickly go, oh, there must be a thought behind this. What is this thought? Yes. And once you have got that awareness around the thought, it's just simply say to yourself, okay, now I know what I don't want that's producing these emotions, and then ask yourself this question, what is it that I do want? Really simple, quick way of refocusing is just asking yourself, okay, I know what I don't want now, but what is it that I do want? And really embodying the emotions behind that. But yeah, great advice. And can you tell us a little bit about, you mentioned diminishing behaviors. What are those, Luka, and why should we be aware of them?
Oh, absolutely. This is something that I have been working around with my own coach, actually, and they're quite interesting. So there's six of them. Now, I cannot remember them all off the top of my head, but a few of them are procrastination, perfectionism, overwhelm. Dang. If the other ones come back to me, I will 100% shoot them off. But essentially, we go through these patterns, and we generally have about two or three that we have play out, right? Mm-hmm. There's another one, a know-it-all mentality. That just came to me. I can't remember the other two. But basically, we have these diminishing behaviors, and it's not something that needs to be removed with timeline therapy, or that is a major problem or anything. That it's just something to be aware of and to really sit and reflect and just think, right, where do I go? And I have an influx of interest on a program that I'm offering, or where does my mind go when I have a long list of things to do in my day? For a lot of people, they will look at what they've got to do for the day. They'll go into slight overwhelm of how am I going to get this all done in the day? Mm-hmm. And then they might move into procrastination. And then even if they do eventually get around to dipping their toe in and doing a little bit of work, it's got to be perfect. So they use perfectionism as a reason not to produce whatever it is that needs to be done.
Right. It's so crazy, but so true. And I can absolutely see even just the ones that you were able to reflect. All of those have been present in my behaviors. Definitely procrastination. Absolutely have, you know, recently done a post on perfectionism and overwhelm. That is such a, and they're such self-sabotaging behaviors, aren't they?
Absolutely. And I think that at the core of them as well, it comes back down to fear of not being good enough, or fear of judgment. Again, if someone did judge you, what would you make that mean about you? For me, if someone judges me, I it goes straight over my head. I wouldn't even know unless they told me directly, but I'm so certain on who I am. And that's probably why I don't experience as much fear as someone who maybe is starting out, because I'm aware that people judge me based on their level of thinking, based on the psychology that they currently have, based on their model of the world. Who am I to judge them for judging me? So the fear can diminish far easier. The more certain you get on yourself, the more aligned you are and the more belief you have in yourself. Because as long as, again, intention is a huge part in that, as long as you're coming from pure intention, then you cannot do any wrong.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter if you stuff up on a live, or you get tripped up on your words, or you spell there and there wrong. I see it all the time. It's not something something to feel ashamed of or to feel fear to the point of not even doing it in the first place, though.
Yes. I'm hearing another great takeaway question here.
Yes.
Something to journal on and something to ask yourself to raise that self-awareness, and that is, what do you make that mean about yourself? How good is that question? And what can you make that mean about yourself instead to replace that belief, as that will severely help you overcome some of those fears, surely, particularly ones around fear of judgment. That's so good.
Yeah, totally. And there's so many different concepts I could dive so heavily in, but I definitely maybe will revisit this, but just mindset alone and what we make everything in our life mean is just a total reflection of who we are and where we are at that point. And that's a whole nother story. I could go so deep into that. I will save that for another one. But yeah, everything is just a choice. We choose to feel the emotions we do. We choose to feel the thoughts that we do. The fastest way to change your thoughts, even if you are stuck in what feels a spiral, how you were talking about before, the manifestation, you're like, oh my God, I'm manifesting all these bad things. Because like the fastest way to break that is to actually change your physiology. So if you literally jumped up and started squatting or star jumps or something, your mind, you break that pattern straight away, and then you've got to choose a different thought. Right, okay, the pattern's broken. I'm sweaty, I'm hot, I'm short of breath. Cool, I can notice all those things. What do I choose now? Yes. And I think having clarity and direction of where you want to go as opposed to where you don't want to go. I think so many people know what they don't want. They don't want their past. Okay, we'll stop focusing on your past. Focus on what you do want. Gain clarity on what you do want. Make a game plan for what you do want.
So have a game plan for snapping out of it, I'm hearing.
Totally.
I think that is playing my favorite jam.
Yeah.
The fastest way for me to change my physiology is just to play some sort of music that just makes me feel a different way, gets me every time. And then, yeah, it's just that slap across the face that you need and go, okay, wake up, Jeff. What are you going to focus on now? Because if you don't have that game plan, you can just totally, it can... one bad day can turn into one bad week, can turn into one bad month, and the next minute you're just finding yourself really giving up on your dreams and your strategies and all the hopes that you've had for your business. So such great advice there as well. I've got one for my fellow mums, because I'm sure there will be some 100 tuning into this episode, and from one mama to the other, any tips on juggling motherhood and business, and what have been your biggest challenges with this?
Oh yeah, I would say at the beginning, my biggest challenge was investing in myself. I'm responsible for a child. Who am I to spend money on myself? Who am I to go away to develop myself in my mind when I have a new baby? And that was something that I had to overcome. But I thought, how is this having this guilt, if I'm going to do this, how is having this guilt going to serve me? And what is that going to demonstrate to my child? Children do not follow all that we say. They follow all that we do. And that was the biggest thing. I need to demonstrate to her what greatness looks for me and what internal fulfillment looks for me and what happiness and love and all the rest of that looks for me, because I want to be the best example for her to have something to model that from. I don't need her to be a smaller version or a younger version of me at all, but I want to demonstrate to her what great relationships are. I want to demonstrate to her that she can do anything she wants. She doesn't need to be a coach. She could go to university, but I'm going to demonstrate to her that she should 100% put herself first and go for what she wants. But it's not enough for me just saying that. I had to do that. And I think that goes with everything in life. The relationship that you're in, your health, your fitness, how you manage your money. Our children are subconsciously taking in everything that we do. So I think, living in alignment with who you want to be, that highest version of you, that's a wonderful example for your children. But it's just not enough to tell them.
What comes to mind is I read an amazing book by Glennon Doyle just recently called Untamed. If you guys have not read it, I think it is a bestseller at the moment, incredible book. And she talks about this death of the mother and the motherhood that comes with motherhood, I guess. And what that teaches, particularly our daughters, I mean, and our sons too, but are we teaching them that once you have a child, particularly for a baby girl, are you teaching her that once you become a mom, that's the end of you? That's the end of your dreams. That's the end of your life. That's where your life ends. And it just hit me. That's so powerful. Same as boys. What are we teaching them? That when a girl becomes a mama, that her dreams aren't important anymore, that her health isn't important anymore, that who she is and the impact that she's here to create and her purpose isn't important anymore.
Hold up, girlfriend. Before you go, I have a gift for you. I'm giving away a free 3-day event where I teach you live how to overcome your fears of starting a business and discover your profitable niche. I know firsthand how overwhelming it might feel to know you want to share your gifts with the world and create impact, but feel overwhelmed with where to start. Which of your passions are going to result in profits while at the same time feeling fearful of failure and lacking certainty within yourself and your abilities? So I wanted to help declutter your mind, help you reconnect with your soul so that not only is your business going to result in wealth, but also happiness. In this course, you'll receive strategy as well as mindset exercises that will help you literally rewire your brain and ditch your negative thought patterns that are currently holding you back. Even if you already have a business, this course will be sure to provide you with some serious value. Oh, I'm sorry. And did I mention that I have got a $2,000 giveaway out for grabs? You have to join the course and participate in order to find out how to enter the chance to win a $2,000 breakthrough package with me. The only criteria is that if you loved this podcast and what it's all about, you hit the subscribe button, then share the podcast with your friends in your IG story. You then head over to the podcast notes and click on the Facebook group link where the course will be live streamed. Lastly, I want you to play full out. You will have the opportunity to create instant changes in your life and business if you implement what I teach and participate in the course. So head over to the page and introduce yourself. I cannot wait to meet you in the group.
So this one is for the overwhelmed solopreneurs who may or may not have babies, but might be juggling a full-time job, feeling like they're being pulled into 1,000 different directions. So if you were to give them one thing to focus on walking away from today's podcast, what would it be?
Great question. I think it would be to just start somewhere, whether it's to get in proximity with someone virtually, meaning Instagram, Facebook, group chats, things like that. Get in proximity with those who are making it happen, those who have children but who are also building their dream life. You've got to be surrounded by those who support the vision to begin with, to build that momentum. So get in proximity with those who are doing what you want to be doing. It becomes infectious. You can't help but want to show up when you feel so inspired by seeing other people show up each day. And they're the people essentially that you're going to learn the most from. They're where you want to be. They know the steps that they took in order to get there. So proximity is power. And it's such a cliche statement, but it's so freaking true.
Oh my God, I love that advice. That is so great. Well, Luka, thank you so much. This has been, wow, just incredible value. I feel like there's so many golden nuggets in this episode. I'm so excited to get this out to our lovely audience. So what I would like to do is just the last question that I have for you is, could you please tell these beautiful women that are tuning in, where else can we find you?
Oh, beautiful. Yes. My Instagram handle is Luka, L-U-K-A _Rose. With 2 E's, or you can search my business name on Facebook. My website is currently getting an upgrade, but it would just be lukarose.com.au. But if you want to pop it in the show notes, my name's a little bit tricky, as you can probably understand. But yeah, absolutely. Find me there. I do, you know, so much free content, whether it be Facebook groups, Instagram, ebooks, all the rest of it. So there's so much content that you can absorb if you head over there and just check it all out.
Yes, we love an account that gives out lots of free value. I'm sure that's going to be somewhere the girls are going to go straight to. So I'll definitely add that in the show notes for you ladies. But we really hope you enjoyed this episode today. Again, Luka, thank you so, so much for your time today. We really appreciate you having been on this episode, and have a lovely rest of the day.
Thanks so much, Dee. Speak
no
soon.
No worries. Love you guys. Bye. Hey, business bestie. Thank you so much for choosing to tune into the Her Soulful Success podcast. Don't forget to check out the show notes for all of the links, including my private Facebook group community, Passion to Profit, where I share even more free content, freebies, and live events for the ambitious business babe. If you loved what you heard today, you're going to love what I have in store for you. Everything from creating beautiful brandy, money mindset and wealth, nutrition for optimal energy and mood, to energy healing and anxiety management. I got you. I am covering like all of the things to support you on your journey to soulful success. So that you don't miss out on future episodes, don't forget to click subscribe and share the podcast with your tribe. If you share it on your socials, don't forget to tag me so that I can say hi and thank you personally.